studio production of John Lafarge. It's a major New York glass studio in the 19th century, direct competitor of Blue Comfort Tiffany. Did a really significant work for significant clients, including the Vanderbilts, including a lot of major churches. And to have this here in Morristown is quite special. And we know that she's enthroned in heaven because you have two angels here. And the angels, they're punti. So you have face and face and wing and wing. What Lafarge was doing and what Louis Comfort Tiffany were doing at essentially the same time was, instead of using the glass as a canvas on which to paint and create a scene, they were really pushing the medium of glass to its limits to use it for its own properties. So there's very little paint on this window. The faces are painted, Cecilia's hands are painted, but other than that, it's all glass. So when you're looking at this, drapery is suggested. Do you see how the glass is rippling? That's suggested by the glass itself. These columns here, they're really not columns, but they're meant to frame the niche-like columns. These are chunky glass jewels. So each one of these would have refracted and reflected the light, and it really would have had the effect of glittering when we see the light through it in a year or 18 months. So the glass was specifically selected for its color, its texture. It was treated, so these are pressed. These are smooth pressed glass jewels. These are kind of chunks of glass. This is rolled on a roller to get this. Sometimes, and we can't really see it here, but you'll see the glass in the mantle, in her robe, will really be thick and kind of drippy. It almost looks drippy because it's mimicking fabric. It was chosen to mimic the drape. This here, it's early. It's an early American, decorative window. It's 1886. It has significance to Morristown. It has significance to the state. And it really does have significance in the history of American decorative art. So it's really a treasure to have here.